All right, everybody, welcome to Bitten Apple TV. This is Marty Grabstein, the voice of Courage the Cowardly Dog. And I'm over here with Chantel, Ralph, and Leslie, and we're gonna start the show right now.
Hey everybody, this is Les, aka Sister Slayer, here at the Greater Philly Con, and I'm here with the Bitten Apple TV in conjunction with It Came From the Radio, and we are at Source Point Press, which is one of my favorite booths by all times. They have the coolest booth here. It's in the center of everything, and you can't walk by without stopping. But I am here with Mr. Greg Wright. He is one of their creative writers, and he has told me about some of the stuff. I actually bought it, and I can't wait to read it, of some of his work that he's done. So I'm going to have him talk a little bit about himself and then show you some of his comics. Wonderful. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Leslie. I'm so grateful that you're stopping and talking with me. Happy to be here.
I'm happy to interview you. Wonderful. All right. So, Greg, tell me a little bit of how you got started with Source Point Press. And I know you guys came in from Michigan. They're from the Midwest. Yay. Shout out to everybody from the Midwest. They're from Michigan.
Yes.
Just let me tell me about this, because I see you guys at a lot of East Coast cons.
Yes, yeah. We travel all over. I've been this year so far to Washington, D.C., Philadelphia, obviously, Dallas, Chicago, all over the place, Cleveland, Columbus. We've been all over, and it's really exciting to get to meet new people all over the country. But in terms of a little bit about, did you want to know about my background as well? So like I said, my name's Greg Wright. And I come from a background, I got my PhD in English from Michigan State, and so I teach creative writing, I teach composition writing, stuff like that, lots of cool things. And I've done writing for a number of years, started writing comics, graphic novels, things like that, and it's been a lot of fun. I hooked up with Source Point Press a couple years ago, now I have several projects working with them. It's been a lot of fun, and I love getting to meet people. You can probably hear it in my voice that I'm already losing it a little bit, because I talk to a lot of people every time I get a chance.
He's a good salesman, but you know what? His comics actually sell themselves, because I came over here and I looked at it and I was like, okay, how much is this? How much is this? And he was actually trying to give me a deal because, you know, we're the Bitten Apple, but no. He hooked it up, but I was glad to pay the price. I'm very interested in a couple of things that he's written. This one right here, Holliston. So tell us a little bit about this one.
This is a tie-in with Adam Green's cult TV show, Holliston, about him growing up in Holliston, Massachusetts. He's an independent horror filmmaker, and in this, you've got him and his friends finding a cursed credit card, threatens to destroy them, their friendship, and the town of Holliston itself. It got written up in Entertainment Weekly. There's giant monsters, killer robots, and kids from Cannibal Fat Camp. There's gorgeous art in here by Steve Schar and Josh Werner, who've both done work for Marvel. So it's really exciting. There's another one coming. This one's called Friendship is Tragic. The next one's called Carnival of Carnage. It's coming out in a couple months here. So keep an eye out for it.
Yeah, I'm gonna definitely, if I like this and I'll get a review on this, I will definitely be doing Carnival of Carnage.
That's wonderful.
And one of the other things that I liked was the Wild Bullets. Yes, thank you.
So yeah, we got Wild Bullets here. It's about the Bullet family, and they are, as you might guess, trigger-happy, dysfunctional pulp adventurers. There's a detective, a mad scientist, a monster hunter, and an archaeologist. And they all go to their parents' house for Thanksgiving. There's a murder. They have to figure out who's behind it and find a way to work together. And we also have Christmas, which is the new one, where they go for Christmas. There's a plot to blow them up, and they have to wind up stopping it. But they also each take a turn telling a story, and when they do, a different artist takes over in a different style and genre. So you have a mix of pulp crime, horror, sci-fi, and adventure, all in one cool story here about Christmas and Thanksgiving, respectively.
So let me ask you, these are stories that they're telling about gun violence, or is it just any story? They just sit around and tell stories.
It's gun themed in that the sci-fi guy has a ray gun, you know, and that sort of a thing. But it's not necessarily about that. It's more about like the pulp adventure of it all, right? And they certainly do have itchy trigger fingers and things like that. But this is more in like the vein of like Indiana Jones and classic detective stories and stuff like that.
Okay, so you hear that, kids. This is not about gun violence. This just is about...
It's more about fun and adventure and things like that. So, yeah.
I wanted to correct that.
No. Just not trying to make a political statement one way or the other about it.
No. People will go there sometimes, you know. All right.
We have Monstrous here. This is an exciting story. This is the fifth one out of five stories, so they're all one-shots. People can buy them and read them in any order. In this one, Dr. Frankenstein and Dr. Jekyll go on a cross-country road trip rescue mission with Mr. Hyde along for the ride. Nobody's as they seem, everybody's a little bit monstrous. All of them are set in Frankenstein's Europe with steam-powered robots fighting against your classic monsters. So there's Dracula, werewolves, zombies, and Igor doing tech support on brains in jars.
How do you come up with this stuff?
I probably have something wrong with me. You should medicate it away, I think.
No, that's genius. It really is. It is.
Thank you so much.
It's genius. Now, I can't wait to look at this one. I have to tell you that I thought this looked like Daryl from The Walking Dead.
Kind of got that vibe. Yeah, yeah, I'm with you.
That's even more reason to read it.
Thanks so much.
All right, so we have everything. Where can we find you guys next? Because I know you guys are traveling. I know you're going to be here again tomorrow, but where else can we find you guys? And where are you going to be next?
We are going to be doing the Motor City Comic Con in May. That's in the Detroit area. We do cons all over. And so look for us at your local Comic Cons. If you've got an event, we love hearing from people, hooking things up. You can check us out at sourcepointpress.com. We've got Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, all that stuff. I'm on, I have a Facebook, and I have my own website at gregwrightbooks.com. And you can check me out on Twitter at Greg Henchman and at Greg Wright Books.
See, I told you he was a salesman because normally I have to ask people to give me that information.
Right.
What? This man. I'll tell you. I can't wait to dig into this.
Oh, thank you so
much. I really can't, and I can't wait to do my review on it. And I can't wait to see you again.
Oh, you're so kind.
Yes. So we're going to definitely, you know, we're always taking a bite out of Source Point Press. They are fabulous, amazing. They're from the Midwest, which means to tell me that I'm from good stock because, Midwest folks. And they're an amazing team. So let's keep following them, and we'll have more news about them soon.
Who loves Bitten Apple?
Oh. Kale loves Bitten Apple. I do. Ooh. The Bitten Apple, y'all.